Boys, what's up? I know it's a little bit early, kind of seems like it at least. You know, it's the middle of summer, it's 90 plus degrees here in Minneapolis. The baseball teams, the Austin Greyhounds and the Rochester Roadrunners, they're two games away from the playoffs. Like, the All-Star game just happened yesterday in Major League Baseball, literally the mid-summer classic. It doesn't feel like fall is very close right now, honestly. But if you go to our fantasy football page and you look at this countdown that's been going for a couple months, it's now down under 30 days. Right now it says 25. It might still be summer, but it is also that time. Training camp's gonna start in a week or two here for most NFL teams. It's time to get ready for season two. The MFL is way closer than you would think. Kevin Andrews has had the belt for a prosperous offseason. But it's about time to let the hounds loose, and 11 other teams are going to go try and take it from them. This video is going to detail everything that has changed from season 1 to season 2, rule changes, buy-ins, all that, just all housekeeping to get it out of the way before the draft and then before we make a big season preview. Hopefully we get in and out, but this is your reminder, the MFL is back. Let's go play this damn music.
Same like the whole city go against me. Every time I'm in the street, I hear yak, yak, yak.
So a lot of this first segment I did cover in the State of the Federation video that we dropped back in May. So if you remember most of that, feel free to skip ahead, although there is some new information on how we're going to break down the cash this year. So don't skip ahead too far, but you can skip ahead a little bit if you remember what I said then. If you don't, I'll still say it for you right now. So we're going to welcome in two new people and tell you about rebrands before we get into the cash. The two new people in this league are Ryan Bechkevich, BZ, and Tommy Greco. So there's now a big group of people in this fantasy football league. I think it's five, actually. BZ, Tommy, Gavin, Ryan Beery, and myself that all went out to Breckenridge, Colorado right at the end of the MFL season last year. It was about like late January, something like that. And now we got basically a majority of the people that were on that trip in this league. So that's going to be very fun. A lot of rivalry games in store. BZ joining a fine Pilsner and Ryan Beery. Tommy Greco joining Gavin Sparks and the Mason City, not Muppets, the Mason City MCs now. Go ask them what that is. I know what it is, but you got to go figure it out for yourself. The Mason City MCs, Gavin Sparks and Tommy Greco. Two other rebrands concerning two of the three Roadrunners in this league and the Gentleman's Classic participants. Lucas James and the Rochester Roadfuckers are now called Deontay's Johnson after he swung a trade with Graham Sparks to land Deontay Johnson from the No Source Schefters, sending over, I think it was Elijah Mitchell and Damian Harris. And then it's like Deontay Johnson, Melvin Gordon. I don't exactly remember. Either way, Lucas also has a team name in baseball called Cease Nuts. So he's got the Johnson and a pair of nuts. Good job, Lucas. Welcome in. Then Hot Chub Time Machine, Robert Schmidt. It's not Hot Chub Time Machine anymore as he shops Nick Chubb on the trading block. He's now named his team after a player that I don't think will move anytime soon. The University of Minnesota's own Baltimore Raven, Rashad Bateman. Baby Bateman is now the team name for Robert Schmidt's squad. Row the boat, Sky Uma. I hear, yeah, Nick Chubb is on the block. So if you're going to go into this draft, make your offers and see what happens. I don't know how that'll go. So there we go. That's that is rebrands and new owners. Let's talk about buy-ins and the cash. So we decided on $40. That's what we said in the Federation video. Half of the league voted for it. So barely like on the line of a straight up majority, but it was definitely the most common answer. So we're going to do $40 for this year. We have a new Venmo. And it's going to be run by Gavin. He is now the treasurer of all Federation leagues. So for any league, if you're in multiple, but especially for football, since we're talking about that right now, please Venmo at SHFFed right here. You got to find the profile. It looks like that. Go to Venmo and Venmo that account $40, please. That will go to Gavin, and Gavin will keep track of it until it's time to pay people out. We would like to have this done by kickoff for week one, which is September 8th. If that's going to be an issue, please let me know and we can accommodate. You know, it's fantasy. It's not like it's that crazy. We're not going to be crazy sticklers about it, but we would like as much money in there as we can by September 8th so we don't have to worry on the back end and we can get money out immediately when the season is over. That would be very cool. All right, so the cash breakdown, it's $40 now, so a total cash pool of $480. That is double last year. It was a $20 buy-in for a $240 pool. So there's going to be, we had two options, I guess. I could have either loaded up the champion with a bunch of money and kept, you know, division titles and third place stuff the same. That was one avenue. Or we could spread out the money a little bit more. Everyone, like the champion gets just a little bit more, but then there's more people that get money. And I think after what we saw year one, where teams just go up and down depending on the weeks, and we're going to do 1 week long playoffs again this year, I think that second option, spreading the money out a little bit more, is the better call. So you have, right now, you have a better chance of winning some money than not. 7 of the 12 teams in this league are guaranteed to win some sort of money, although probably a majority of those teams won't make all of their money back. They'll get something back. So here's what we're going to do. If you make the playoffs, you get $20. So you're going to get half of your money back just for making the playoffs. The consolation tournament winner will also receive $20. So there's at least some incentive to keep setting your lineups. The last place punishment, not yet been decided, but it will be the loser of the consolation tournament, not the team that has the number one overall pick as the worst record in the regular season. So there is incentive to keep setting your lineups for two different reasons. There's money at the top of the consolation tournament for the winner of it, and then there's a punishment for those who decide to turn in early and not set anything through December. So that's the consolation tournament. Winner of that gets $20. That's why we have 7 of the 12 teams, 6 playoff teams plus that consolation winner. Teams that will get their money back. So division winners win $40. Third place wins $40. And all of these prizes get on top of each other. So if you're a division winner, obviously you make the playoffs, you will get $60. But it's $40 for winning the division, $20 for making the playoffs. You got me? So third place also gets $60. The second place prize is $70, up from $40 last year, but you would get $90 because you made the playoffs. And the winner will receive $150. It's only up $10 from the championship prize last year of $140. Of course, there's the playoff bonus built into it, so it's really $170. So I think the maximum amount you could win is making the playoffs, winning your division, and winning the championship, which would be $210. That's the maximum payout this year for the MFL. And of course, the championship winner receives the belt, which is always very nice. So there's your cash breakdown. I'll go talk about roster updates and scoring updates, and then we're actually out of here. So yeah, housekeeping updates, keep it moving. So this year, the active roster has increased by 3. The total roster size, the maximum amount of people you could ever have on your roster is 26. The amount of starting slots have stayed the same at 13. However, we've taken one out and put one in, but 13 remains the amount of starters. We have 2 IR slots. I haven't changed that. Don't plan to this year, but 3 more bench slots. So you had 8 people on your bench last year. You're allowed up to 11 this year. So if you don't have anyone on your IR, your maximum amount is 24. If you have 2 people maxed out on your IR, your people on your roster is 26. So that one starting slot that we've taken out is special teams. Sorry, Elliot, but the legend of the Jets defense and special teams will live forever as just that, a legend. There is one way for them to score points, although I don't think they're allowed to be in the flex slot. So even if they do score points, it would be on your bench. That empty special team slot has been taken up by a second flex slot. So another spot for you to put running backs, wide receivers, or tight ends. League seemed down for it. There was no majority on like what we wanted to do. That was a question where Lucas was asking, do we want to add a third wide receiver and a second flex and all that? And there were multiple options. Nothing stood out as like a runaway pick. So as a commissioner, I just went in and said, it's probably a good idea to give teams a little bit more flexibility with a second flex slot. I think it will help make the league a little bit more predictable, and it will favor teams that are built better. Teams that are a little bit deeper that had to pick one flex last year will be able to start a second guy. So it's going to favor deeper teams, and deeper teams will win more often on a more regular basis. That is the hope, at least. So two flexes for next year, two wide receivers, two running backs, one quarterback, one tight end. One thing to keep in mind for next year, I'm thinking I want to do this next year. Didn't pass the owners this year, but just something that I thought was good came from Shu. Second quarterback. I'm thinking of implementing that next year. So as you go through this season and you see a guy that you want to pick up and stash, know that that's something that I would like to do next year as the rosters will expand even more. We're going to get more rookies in, so it'll be good to add another slot for a quarterback and get those mid-tier guys on a starting lineup. That's what I'm thinking. Those are your roster updates for this year. Now for the scoring. On the offensive side, it remains basically the same. Passing totals have not changed. Receiving totals have not changed. Rushing totals have not changed. None of that whatsoever. The changes are in defensive scoring as we took away the special team side of things. We're going to rely more on individual players. We also went in with the goal of leveling out the playing field between linebackers who were way up here last year and then defensive backs and defensive linemen that weren't performing as highly in terms of points scored. So I've done a couple of things to try and even it out. Hopefully it works this year. Probably some tweaks coming next year as well until we get it nice and where we want it to be. So for a fumble recovery and a forced fumble, we're going to 3 points per. That is up from 2 points for a forced fumble and one for a fumble recovery last year. So if you had like a strip sack and you stripped the ball and you recovered it, it'd be worth 3 last year. Now it's worth 6. So we've doubled that. Good for hopefully defensive linemen. That's who that's meant for. The 5-tackle bonus next up, that was something that really set the linebackers apart from the competition last year. The 5-tackle bonus still does exist, but I moved it down. It was 3 points last year. If you hit those round numbers, 5, 10, 15, it was 3 bonus points. Now it's just 1. So hopefully that, you know, there, it's a bonus for the more tackles you get, which I think is good. But it's just not as much. And we had a couple of games that got decided by 5-tackle bonuses. I don't want that to happen. I really don't. Because you should know who won a matchup on Monday night or Tuesday morning. You shouldn't have to come back on Wednesday and see, oh my God, the entire league is different. So that's in the hopes of making it more predictable. It's what we did. Interceptions are 4 points instead of 2. That's what was voted on by the owners. I'm cool with that. Good for defensive backs. Another thing good for defensive backs, passes defensed is up to 2 points instead of just a half last year. So defensive backs up, defensive linemen up, linebackers down. We'll see if it's too much of a correction or if it's just right. Hopefully it is. I think it is. We'll just have to wait and see. The last thing that I put in just as an aside, if any player or special teams unit becomes the first player slash special teams unit in NFL history to record the elusive 1-point safety, it's worth 1,000 points. It's never happened. Go look up the John Boyce video, but it's there, and that's worth 1,000 points, an absolute cheat code in honor of the Jets defense and special teams that will not be able to score points this year. So that one goes out to Elliott and Ligma and the Jets. Let's talk about the draft. One more breath. We'll give you everything you need to know on the draft, and then we're out of here. The tournament schedule for the Austin Greyhounds and Rochester Roadrunners has been released. I'll put it up right here. And as you look to both ends of the tournament, right, the double elimination kind of thing, you'll see that there's a lot of games on the 12th, a lot on the 13th, but none on Sunday, August 14th. So that is when we will have our two drafts. The rookie draft will start first right at 4 o'clock, and that's entirely manual. We'll have to get into a Zoom chat, or as many people we can get to the house, we'll take that. But we do need at least someone from each team in attendance there to make their picks, because that is something that I will record manually. The St. Thomas Disciples are still on the clock. I think I know who they're going to pick, but I'm not entirely sure who they're going to pick, so we'll just have to see. It's only four teams picking in the top 8, I believe. And then the second round, we get a bunch more teams in, so it's really playing the Disciples, Baby Bateman now, the Brain Damage, and the Millers are now back in twice in the top 8 after I traded DeAndre Hopkins away. After the rookie draft, I'm not thinking the rookie draft will take 2 hours. It's only 36 picks, but I do have a buffer zone in there. The free agency auction draft starts at 6 o'clock, and that is the countdown that ESPN is referring to. You don't have to keep the rookies that you draft at 4 o'clock, right? Because the way we're going to put those rookies on your roster, if you've been through baseball or basketball drafts like this, you know how we do this. It's just the honor system. That's why we should have and really need everybody, or at least someone from every team in that ESPN draft. So when a rookie gets nominated, don't bid on them. Like, that's the whole point. It's honor system. I can change things after the fact if I need to, but I really don't want to, because that's going to mess up the money side of things for the free agency draft if someone starts bidding on a player that's already been claimed. So that is kind of the deal. The rookie draft acts as you claiming the rights to a player, and then you can either draft that player onto your roster for a dollar in the free agency draft, or let them go and instead go swing for some bigger people. That's how that works. Yeah, that's about it. 4 o'clock for the rookie draft, 6 o'clock for the free agency draft, and then we will be good to go. So after that, on August 14th, we'll do that, and then I'll get to work on a season preview, and then week one kicks off the 8th of September. Oh my God, we're 6 weeks away from it. That's all I have to tell you for right now. So we would love to have you at the house for this draft August 14th. There is a Facebook invite out there and also in the Snap group if you want to go and find that one. But yeah, the 14th of August, I have it starting at 3. You can show up basically at any point during the afternoon, and we'll start the rookie draft at 4 and go from there. So until then, thank you for sticking around in the league. Welcome to our new people, and get ready. Start doing your research, who you're going to draft, who your targets are, because week one is going to be on us before we know it, and we'll be back into football season, and it's going to be like we blinked, man. Crazy, crazy. Season two is upon us. Thanks for sticking around. Thanks for being here, and I will see you on August 14th in this very house. Good luck. Have fun. Set your lineups. Peace out. Wake your punk ass up. It ain't nothing but a Compton thing. Chill. Real simple and plain. We teach you some lessons about the street.